Namaste, welcome to Home Hashtag Life. In today's video, we are going to tackle fridge cleaning inside out, one important family member of our homes who deserves all the attention. A clean, hygienic fridge is extremely important to keep the items inside fresh and hygienic so that it will remain healthy. Cleaning the fridge periodically is also important to optimize energy consumption. Because of this lockdown situation, most of my schedules have taken a back seat. So yes, confession time, I am really guilty of neglecting the fridge since the lockdown began, and that is why it is so dirty. But I'm taking back the control now. So if you have also fallen behind like me in your cleaning schedules, I really hope that this video is going to motivate you. A quick reminder, subscribe to Home Hashtag Life and find us on Instagram and Facebook for more videos, pictures and life updates. So get ready and clean with me. Pick a day when the fridge is relatively empty, when there are no big batter containers or when the veggies are not overflowing. Pick a day when it will be easier to take out all the items so that it will be easier to manage, especially if you have a small kitchen or less counter space. Homemade cleaning solutions, a scrubbing pad, cleaning cloth, a bowl or bucket of plain water, and some music in the background, we are good to go. I like to keep a baking soda container, one water spray, one vinegar spray handy to clean the fridge. Vinegar gets rid of bad smell. It is also known as natural disinfectant solution. Baking soda helps with scrubbing, which is totally non-toxic, while soap solution gets rid of grease and other spills. Filling a bucket of water and adding few drops of dishwashing liquid along with baking soda will be very handy for a quick clean, especially if you are not going to remove the shelves. Unplug the fridge is extremely important to make sure that the compressor is not strained much and that the energy consumption is optimum. It is advisable to start the cleaning with fridge and then move on to the freezer. The contents in the freezer can remain colder for a longer time once the power is cut off, so that there will be less chances of food contamination. You can also keep few items like cheese slices, paneer, etc. in the freezer if needed while you are cleaning the fridge. I will suggest to have a clean counter without much clutter. Here, since I use shelf liners, most of my fridge shelves aren't very dirty, so cleaning with cloth will suffice. And this way, we can avoid wasting water as well. The shelves that are a bit more soiled, I wash under running water with the help of the scrub. But nothing makes sense anymore. As we are on the deep cleaning spree, let's make sure to clean those shelf crevices. Once you remove the shelves, you will be amazed. I mean, I don't know how they manage to accumulate so much dirt and dust. We can spray on the inside of the fridge, but we should avoid spraying on vents directly. Water should not go inside. As you can see, over the time, vents are stained and a black patch can be seen. I'm using a non-scratch scrubber and a little bit of dish soap to clean the area. Toothbrushes are ideal while we clean. nooks and corners of the shelves, or else we can also use scrub pads and water. And whenever we are deep cleaning the fridge, it is important that we clean the drawers thoroughly. Check the extreme bottom part of the fridge shelf and door. They catch dust and dirt every single day. Make sure that the shelves are completely dry. Even a bit of moisture can result in breeding of microorganisms. So wipe them dry, or you can sun dry them, and we are good to go. Now comes my favorite part, putting back the cleaning shelves and drawers back in its place. As I told you earlier, I like to follow a step-by-step process of removing things and cleaning them, as I don't have much counter space. So here I have cleaned all the shelves and inside the fridge. Now I'll be putting back its content first, then I will start with the fridge door. This way I will not be overwhelmed and I can enjoy the cleaning process. This is good time to take stock of all sauces, pickles, etc. that are sitting on our doors for God knows how many months. If you are the kind of person who periodically checks and discards stuff after expiry dates, if you are very meticulous and systematic, then a big high five to you. Do let me know in the comment section how systematic you are. Well, for me, I review contents like sauces once a year or always check before I cook. Let's remove these door containers now and give them a good wash. Before cleaning any part of the fridge, it is very important that we should know what to wash and what not to wash. Like, this door shelf has a unique feature of odor reduction. There are carbon patches inside and it should not be washed. So I just wiped it off instead of washing it. While they are drying, we can start cleaning the door wall. I use a bit of baking soda to help remove hard spills and stains. I feel it is better to avoid any chemical sprays, as our food items go in there. This is an all important step that we tend to overlook. Check the gaskets. Sometimes the crevices might have accumulated dirt or food particles and may prevent the door from being vacuum tight. Poor seals means bad cooling and may lead to food contamination. It will also make your electricity bills soar through the roof. You can see that the door gaskets have turned black. Here what I am doing is, I am using this non-scratch sponge with diluted dishwashing liquid to remove all these black marks. While we were researching, we read that we can use petroleum jelly to keep the moisture intact for the door gaskets. I'm still not sure. If you guys have any opinion on this, let me know. When I deep clean the fridge, I always make sure to clean the outside properly, especially the top of the fridge, the extreme bottom of the fridge and back side of the fridge. Over the time, the top part catches everyday dust and oil grease, as most of us keep our fridge inside the kitchen. So time to time it needs a good scrub in spite of the fact that we put fridge cover. Now move towards the back side of the fridge which has the coils. Vacuum them or dust them thoroughly. This is also an all important step because when dust accumulates on the coils, it has to work more to maintain the temperature inside of the fridge. What does it mean? Heavy electricity bills and less lifetime of the fridge. So take care of that. Maybe I never knew what I really wanted, but looking back I can see it's all clear. Regarding smells, many refrigerators give out bad odors. This fridge is really so amazing. I have never faced any bad smell because of its special odor control feature. Few tips to make sure your fridge is odor free. Always cover all the food inside. Get the perfect sized lid to cover vessels properly. Never leave curd burton or milk or masala powders packets etc. open. The smells can circulate, spoiling the overall experience of any food. Place a half cut lemon in the far back corner of the shelves to absorb any bad odor. Some people also place a cup of baking soda for the same purpose. Now we are all set with a sparkling fridge. Wait, this video isn't over yet. Once we have cleaned the fridge, we need to organize its contents in an efficient way. And it will be filled with various important informations. So stay tuned for that video and subscribe to Home Hashtag Life for more videos and find us on Instagram and Facebook for more videos, pictures and life updates. Till then, stay home, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye. Thank you.